Welcome to the week that changed the world, day three. Are you having fun? Is God changing your life? Is God giving you some new revelation? Are you growing closer to Him? Well, that's my hope and my prayer. So today I want to pick up when Jesus is coming back to Jerusalem. Jesus was hungry and there was a fig tree, but it had no fruit. And Jesus curses that fig tree. Well, the very next day, 24 hours later, Peter recognizes on the path back into Jerusalem that fig tree that Jesus cursed. And he points it out. Jesus, this is the fig tree that you cursed. It's dead. He was amazed. Jesus' response was not that of amazement. It was that of, why do you doubt? If you believe, these things will happen. The writer of Hebrews says this, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. You know, sometimes God does things right on the spot. We see miracles and we see the manifestation of that. And that's amazing, and I love that about God. But there are other times that we pray, it actually happens, but it doesn't manifest for a day, a week, a month, a year. You know, today God has put promises in your heart. He's put desires in your heart. He's put dreams in your heart. And God is faithful. See, God is a promise maker, but He's also a promise keeper. So today I want to encourage you. What are some of those desires that you believe God's put in your heart? I want you to resurrect some of those desires today. What are you believing for this week? Are you believing for a neighbor, a friend, even to come to church? Are you believing for a loved one, someone in your home? Are you believing for a new job? Are you believing for a healing miracle? Whatever it is, as it lines up with God's promises, stand and believe and receive it. Today, faith comes by hearing and hearing by the Word of God. Even as I'm speaking God's words, faith can be being stirred in your heart to believe and to ask and receive it. And so that's what I want to challenge you is dive in. Let God speak to you. Let God stir you. Even read out loud the passages today. Read it out loud, because as you speak the Word out loud, as you hear the Word of God, it's going to stir faith in your heart to actually go into prayer and to ask and believe. God is faithful. He is a faithful God. He loves you. He is for you. So as you're in the Word, as the Word is being stirred up, pray. And what did Jesus say in this passage? He didn't say, ask me to move the mountain. No, when you know the mountain is in the way of God's plans and His purposes for your life, no, you speak to those mountains. You speak to those circumstances. You tell those things to move. Jesus said, we, His followers, His disciples, we would do what He did and even more. Come on, church. Today's the day. Today's the day to see those greater things in our lives today. Let me pray for you. Let me pray that God would stir up faith in you today to believe God that this is a breakthrough day. Come on. This is a breakthrough day, church, in our lives. Come on. Let's get excited about prayer. Let's get excited about Passion Week. Let's make sure there's some passion in Passion Week. Amen. Let me pray. Father, I thank you. I thank you for your amazing love. I thank you that you love us. I thank you for all the amazing promises we see in the Word for us. Oh God, stir us today. Stir everyone today. Let faith arise. Let us go from no faith or little faith to great faith. Oh Lord, we are blessed. We recognize it. We're so thankful. We're so thankful for all that you've done. And Lord, if you've never do another thing in our lives, you've done more than enough. But God, we're asking for more. So God, I pray for those that are believing for a healing miracle in their own body. I believe it right now in the name of Jesus, you are healed. I'm believing for those right now. If you need a new job, if you're struggling, if there's any debt in your life, Lord, I'm praying for a financial breakthrough, a career breakthrough today. I'm believing with you for your loved ones, for your neighbors, your coworkers that you've been asking, that you've been praying for to come to know Jesus, to come to church. Do it. You are faithful to your word. Thank you. We receive it in Jesus' name. Amen. Don't miss tomorrow's podcast where Jesus goes silent on day number 4 in the week that changed the world.